So what are the steps involved in these types of projects? Before you jump in and write a fancy algorithm, you'll want to spend some time getting familiar with your data. The process begins with a question you want to answer or a problem you want to solve. This might be something like, what are the characteristics of students who pass their projects? Or, how can I better stock my store with the products people most want to buy? The next step of the process is data wrangling, and this really has two parts, data acquisition and data cleaning. First, you need to acquire the data that you need to answer your question or solve your problem. Then it's time to begin investigating the data and cleaning up any problems that you find. The third phase is data exploration. During this phase, you spend some time getting familiar with your data, building your intuition about it, and finding patterns. Once you're familiar with your data, you'll usually want to draw some conclusions about it, or maybe make some predictions. From one of our examples previously, Netflix's movie recommendation system needs to predict which movies its users will like. Also, the Facebook paper we saw concluded that users are less likely to click certain articles, specifically ones written from a different ideological perspective than the user has. This phase usually involves statistics or machine learning that are beyond the scope of this course, but there are additional Udacity courses you can take on these topics if you're interested in learning more. And finally, you'll need to communicate your findings to other people. Your findings are only as useful as your ability to communicate them. Even if your end goal is to build some sort of system, like a movie recommender or a newsfeed ranking algorithm, you'll usually need to share what you've built and how it works with your team. There are a variety of formats this communication can take. You might write a blog post, a paper, an email, a PowerPoint presentation, or just have an in-person conversation. Data visualization is a common technique that's almost always useful when communicating findings about data. Now, this process doesn't actually follow a straight line. Especially the data wrangling phase and the data exploration phase are very intertwined because you can't really clean any problems with the data before you take a look to see what problems there are, and even when you think you're done wrangling and you're ready to just explore, you'll keep finding more problems and have to go back. Throughout the process, you may need to return to your question and refine it as you become more familiar with the data set. And sometimes, data acquisition actually comes before you pose a question. If a new exciting data set is released, you might acquire the data first, take a look and see what's there, and then think of some questions you could answer with the data. That's what we'll be doing in this lesson. However, this should give you an idea of the high-level steps that are involved when you're doing data analysis.